Hola, Star Wars fans, another Star Wars review. This time, the Ewok Assault Catapult, the Return of the Jedi Vintage Collection. This was, I believe, a Kmart exclusive again. Yes, it was. I picked this up at darksidetoys.com. We have Kmart here in Australia, but sadly, they do not stock this item. I was very grateful to the guys at Darkside for stocking it, because otherwise, I'd have to fight with the scalpers on eBay. And it's a beautiful set. So there's the two Ewoks and the catapult. We'll give you a close-up and much more detail of the set as we go through. Let me see if I can sharpen that up a little bit for you. There we go. So again, nice to see the vintage collection really not doing too badly at all, despite it supposedly being on hiatus. This is our third set in just this month that we're reviewing, so good to see it. Stemsy and Chubbry are the two figures that we get. And obviously this Ewok catapult set, a nice little diorama there. And some yada yada about helping the rebels. That's pretty much the box. It's quite tall and large. If I have a standard figure here, here's a G.I. Joe figure we're reviewing in a minute on our Tech Sushi channel. There we go. Pretty big. So it's quite a large scale box for this part. But we'll show you that in a minute. That's the side of the box. Nothing else to tell you. That's it. Right, inside the box you get this little manual, and it gives you the instructions there. To put the catapult together. You probably wouldn't need it, but it does help to just try and understand where it's going to go. So attach catapult arm under front of the toy. And you'll see the little hook there, which first I was a little bit confused about, but then that piece there just explains it all. It just hooks into underneath that part there. So, and we get our rocks. And that's it. That's the instructions. There's nothing on the back of it, just plain white. So let's get a look at this catapult first of all. You get two rocks, get your rocks on, but I have to say, these are, as rocks go, I don't review a lot of rocks, but they're absolutely fantastic. They really look the part. I did pick up a Power of the Force bunker scene, which did have some plastic rocks, and I think the catapult from many, many years ago, and the rocks looked crap. They were just big lumps of empty plastic. These are solid and kind of squidgy, like gigantic big balls of blue tack rubber. They're particularly detailed in a kind of Star Trek rock kind of way, if you know what I mean, polystyrene-ish. But all you old school peeps out there will know exactly what I mean. But each rock has a hole on it, and that allows it to clip on to the, in fact, they're exactly the same. I don't know why I'm showing you the different rock. They both have holes in them, and they're practically identical, so there you go. A nice detail, nice paintwork. There's actually a bit of shading been applied to that. So well done, Hasbro. And you'll see on the catapult itself, we've got some nice weathering and detail too. So we've got kind of a green mossy effect on the side there. And also the rope also has weathering and sculpting on that too, which I really, really like. Really good job, Hasbro. Even the wood has a nice effect on it as well. That kind of wooden handle as opposed to the timber there. Nice. I think just really, really nice sculpting on this. I believe this is a brand new piece. If I'm wrong, let me know in the comments below. But I'd love to know. So again, if you're looking to buy this, there's a link directly underneath the video to go and buy it at Dorfside. Please head on, get it, grab it while it goes, before it goes, because again, you do not want to pay the prices online. So everything's all molded in one piece, and you'll see as per the instructions, there's where the hook goes underneath and kind of clips in, and that allows that to all be pulled together. Again, there's not much to show you underneath. It's kind of hollow, a couple of serial numbers, but even then there's still paint underneath. So it's beautifully done. Really, really nice piece. Not a huge fan of Ewoks, but even the ropes, not just, normally you just get a single strand of string, but you'll see there if I begin to, he says, if you can pull that down, there we go, you'll see the canopy start moving. If I hold on to that, just for you, I'm going to fire off a rock, everybody. There we go. So I'm going to put the rock, I feel like saying a rock lobster here. Where's the hole on the rock? There's the hole in the rocks. There we go. Put the hole on the rock, and we'll let the canopy go. One rock fired. There you go. So that's pretty much it. It's a catapult. But again, nicely done, nicely sculpted, nice weathering. Good job, Hasbro. Let's get a look at the Ewoks. So Ewok number one is Chubbry, which I'm calling a bit of a female kind of Ewok here. I'm not quite sure what's going on with the lipstick on there. Female or not? I maybe should have looked up Wikipedia for the review, but I'm sure someone can tell me. But it's definitely got full-on lipstick going on there. But nice weathering. It's pretty much the standard body used for Ewoks of old. Or late, I should say. But again, nice sculpting, nice weathering on that body. You will notice there is no elbow joints on this figure, and I'll explain more about that in a minute. That one's a kind of fixed pose. And there's his heart, little Ewok butt. And it's got a nice cloth cape on there with nice kind of sculpting on the mask, or head dress, whatever you want to call it. A very nice facial sculpt there. There's nothing underneath the headdress at all. It's just a standard Ewok head, but quite cute, very well done. Little kind of glassy brown eyes and the nose, and of course those lips, and that spear there again. Nice sculpting and paintwork. It's a good job. Even Hasbro have painted their fingernails. There you go. So you'll see from this figure, of course, it's got a swivel head on it. It's got swivel arms, and it's also got ball joints on those arms too, so they do move. Swivel paws and swivel little hairy tummy, swivel hips, and it's even got little articulated toes. There you go. So uber cute, very, very cool little Ewok. That's Chubbry. And Stemsy, there we go, looking at the box, is a kind of, I love this guy. He's just got a very glazed look on him. It's like, hey man, just found some mushrooms in the forest. I don't know, it's little sparkly eyed with his little smile there, very cool. So he's also got his, look at Flair, it's very late tonight when I'm doing this. He's got his little headdress on there, again with slightly different sculpting, so still looking the part. And you'll notice this guy does have articulated elbows, so he's a super articulated Ewok, so there you go. He's got stripes down his fur, again little painted toenails and fingernails, so again nicely sculpted, nicely painted. Instead of the spear is slightly different from the other one. There, one has got a pointed arrow, and Stemsy's got a kind of rounded tip there on that. Finar, finar. And in terms of articulation, ball jointed head on him, ball joint with a hinge at the shoulders, ball joint with a hinge at the elbows. He's got swivel paws, swivel waist, swivel hips, or ball joint with a hinge at the hips, I should say. It's not swivel hips at all, I lied. So ball joint with a hinge on them, and of course these tiny little ball joint with a hinge at the toes, and he just about has some peg holes there. Yes, he does. Very generous, actually. So that's not a bad pack. Again, two great looking Ewoks. Can't remember the price I paid, but it was not expensive at all. I saw some shocker prices for this on eBay, which was just like, are you high? But that's what people do. They rush into Kmart and they see these things cheaply, and of course they then double the price, triple the price, and shove them up on eBay. So that's why I buy it Dorkside. So again, if you want to leave a comment, let us know what you think. Are you buying it? Is it one you can pass, or is it a must-have? Love to hear your thoughts. Are you happy the vintage collection is still trucking on? I sure am, that's for sure. Love the packaging, love the figures, but again, love to know your thoughts in the comments below. You'll find all the other stuff in the comments below as well, or that section below, where to buy it, and also Instagram, Google+, Twitter, Facebook, all that stuff is on there. And our other channel, Tech Sushi, if you want to check that out too. Lots of Marvel, G.I. Joe, and more. That's it. We'll see you for other reviews coming up.